Okay, today I'm going to show you how to install QuickBooks 2010 to Windows 8. Right from the CD, you don't have to download anything from the internet. So you're going to put your CD in. You're going to go to Computer. You're going to right-click on the DVD drive so you can open up the contents of the CD. You're going to click QuickBooks folder. And then you're going to scroll down to QuickBooks. And it'll say QuickBooks Windows Installer. So you're going to click on that, and it's going to run you through the process. If you try to install directly from the CD, then it's going to try to run Flash ActiveX. And that's where everybody's getting their errors, and that's where I got mine. So I knew there had to be an easier way to do this, although QuickBooks claims that you need to buy an upgrade, so they try to sell you QuickBooks 2014. And Windows keeps wanting to upgrade and make things more confusing. Let me know what you think in the comments section about Windows 8, because I'm certainly not happy with it. I did upgrade to Windows 8.1 before I did this, and it gives you kind of a start menu, but it takes you to the app feature, and I don't know why Windows thought this was a good idea, because it just simply confuses people, and now there's something new to learn, and I use Windows as a filing system, not as entertainment. So maybe they'll come out with Windows 8.2. and switch things back to how they used to be. So give me your thoughts on that. Maybe Windows will read them and we'll get Windows 8.2. Or an option to disable the app feature of Windows. So I fast forward this copying files. It takes, depending on your computer, I mean it takes a while, 10, 15, 20, 30 minutes. But I'm showing you the process, so if you run into any problems, you can see whether I had the same issues, which mine ran smooth. I'll get a pop-up window that says you're going to need to reboot, but that's about it. All right, so I finished this, and I click no here, but you can restart your system here. Instead, I just went to the desktop and restarted it. Alright, so you're going to reboot. Now when you come back up, you're going to click Control Panel. Programs. Programs and features. Run programs made for previous versions of Windows. So simple, yet have not found that explained that way on the information I've read through blogs and help sites. Scroll down and click the program you're having trouble with. In this case, it's QuickBooks Pro 2010. This should work for other versions of QuickBooks, but I can't say I tried them. I'm just showing you what I learned here. So click Troubleshoot. Just click the bottom. I don't know what my problem is, or I don't see my problem. I clicked Windows 7 because it was working on Windows 7. You can try to test the program here. I'm testing it so I can show you that it worked just fine. I have not had any problems using QuickBooks. I've already done this once, so it goes straight to the login for my company file. But yours is going to have new settings, such as open up a file, start a new file, whatnot. That's the only error I had, and it doesn't seem to cause a problem. And there you go. You just saved a couple $100 instead of buying another version. I said next. yes, save these settings because this worked. If it didn't work, don't save it and try to fix it with another version, previous version like XP or Vista. And there you go. And I'm going to reboot the computer, and everything has been working since. So I thought I'd make this video to help people save some money instead of getting bullied into buying an upgrade like QuickBooks tells you you need to. And there's a lot of misinformation out there and complicated ways to do what I just did with a few clicks. A lot of the blogs and information websites I read said to download this file, go into Windows settings and change a bunch of things. Unnecessary. This worked perfectly, and I hope it works for you. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions or problem, leave them in the comment section below and I'll try to answer them. If this video helped, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. Thanks again.